What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to the band, I might mispronounce this, Procol Harum. It has to be one of those. It absolutely has to be one of those. With their song Conquistador, this is from their debut album of the same name as the band, which was released in 1967. I have not heard of this band. I have not heard of them. Procol Harum is an English rock band formed in 1967. Although noted for their Baroque and classical influence, Procol Harum's music also embraces the blues, R&B, and soul. It is a Monday night. I don't know why I chose to record on a Monday night, because Mondays are absolutely the worst day of the week, I would say. But I'm in a good mood. I like my new shirt. Do you guys like my new shirt? Purple is my favorite color, in case you ever wondered. It's the color of royalty. How could it not be? Anyways, I hope that you guys are having an amazing day, an amazing night, whichever day that this video comes out on. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. And let's do it. This is Procol Harum with the song Conquistador.
Conquistador, your stallion stands in need of company. Like some angel's haloed brow, reek of purity. I see your armor-plated breast has long since lost its sheen.
That was it. I thought it was going to be a lot longer. I didn't even know that this song was 2 minutes and 30 seconds. That was a good 2 minutes and 30 seconds. That was a quick song. I want more. I'm left wanting more. It's always a good thing if a band leaves me wanting more, because I thought that was amazing. Singing was great. The guitar riffs, really nice. I'll get into that just a little bit. But it's the organ. The organ adds so much to this song. Throughout the main verse of the song, the organ adds a lot in the background while the piano plays on top of it. Everyone does their thing. Absolutely rips into that solo near the ending of it. I want to see who the organist is. Matthew Fisher is the organist on this one, or at least playing the organ. He is best known for playing the Hammond organ. On Whiter Shade of Pale, another song from them. It looks like that's their most popular song. Yeah, but I really, really enjoyed the way that he was playing there. I love how the space, I can't pause it, sorry. I love how the space is given after like the riffs, and that piano just continues on with the melody. It just continues, bum, 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 bum. The guitar will come in. I absolutely love that. Bear with me on this one. there's potential energy, there's kinetic energy, right? We're getting into physics here. Okay, I love when songs do that, when they have like something like the piano here that just constantly goes bum 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 bum, and then that riff, that guitar riff will come in with the drums, right? Like starting in there. Right? And you hear the energy building up, the song starts to build up, and then eventually it explodes into the chorus. So that's what I mean by potential energy and kinetic energy. I love when songs hold that back, that restraint in the potential energy, and then they build it up and let it go into the kinetic, where that song really gets moving. And sticking with the physics lesson, the inertia, the continued force and movement from the song, it doesn't stop, it continues into that very last chorus, which is just very powerful, and then, of course, into the organ solo. Perfect, perfect. The organ, so energetic in the back. It rips right into it. The drumming is really good too as well. Very, very beautiful drumming going on. High energy and powerful. Love the bass kicking in there in the interim in the song. Even disregarding the subject matter of the song, which is obviously Spanish influence, there's a very, very tiny Spanish influence musically in the music, but it's not, it's very, 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 very subtle. Almost not there. It's really interesting kind of following the history of progressive rock and the music itself. I'm starting to see that like the 60s, and you guys can correct me if I'm wrong because this is something that's all still new to me, but it seems like the 60s were where bands were really experimencing, and as it says, proto-prog, the beginnings and the roots and what it would stem from and eventually grow into, really began in the 60s. And then by the 70s, that's when it really exploded. And then the 80s seemed to have killed off, maybe, most of prog. Some bands transformed and went along with it. Some continued to grow and thrive. But looks like the 70s were the heyday of prog. And the 60s was that those beginnings, those roots were starting to really take water, really start to grow and grow strong so that they could have a solid foundation in the 70s when all these bands really, really exploded with their own unique takes on the genre, with their own flavors and stylings of doing things. This would sound really good if like an orchestra, a little bit more instrumentation in it. Not that it sounds bad. This is just me, you know, daydreaming, I guess now. But this already sounds really good. This is like a nice foundation. I would like to hear it with like some more like, I don't want to say Spanish influence, but like horns, maybe a little bit of strings. But like I said, honestly, I think it's perfect on its own. I really enjoyed this. I would listen to this, first of all. Let's get that out of the way. This was good. It says here that the song is unusual in that the music was written before the lyrics, according to Reed. 99 out of 100 of those Procol Harum songs were written the words first and then were set to music. To me, I feel like most bands write the music before putting lyrics towards it. But it looks like that was actually really off for them. That was unique for them to write lyrics first and then put the music to it. I love the bass and the guitar work too. Bum, 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 bum. Like, I like the riffing overall. Like, everyone comes together actually really well in this song. Is the organ to me really like the coolest part of it? Absolutely. I think that that is solid and probably my favorite part of the song. But that does not take away from the drumming, the bass, or the guitar because they are in their own right really well done, adding a lot to the song. They have their own very memorable riffs, actually, as well. The singing. I really like the singing. It's really good. Excuse me. This became a hit when Procol Harum recorded it live with the Edmonton Symphony Orchestra in 1971. Let me see if I can find that, please. See the power? Mm-hmm. I love it. I love it. There's just something about it with the orchestra that adds so much power to it. And it doesn't take away to me from the song. On its own, awesome. With the orchestra, really good. Like, you know, getting to the lyrics, let's see. Conquistador, your stallion stands in need of company. And like some angel's haloed brow, you reek of purity. I see your armor-plated breast has long since lost its sheen. And in your death-masked face, there are no signs which can be seen. So it looks like there is a conquistador that has been dead for a long time. And the narrator is just talking about the body and what he sees going on. I like how it says, you reek of purity. Like the conquistadors were coming to spread Christianity to South America, but he reeks of purity because he's dead, you know? I just think that's a cool kind of, what is that? Is that hyperbole? I don't think it's hyperbole. Conquistador, a vulture sits upon your silver shield, and in your rusty scabbard now the sand has taken seed. And though your jewel-encrusted blade has not been plundered still, the sea has washed your face and taken its fill. Conquistador, there is no time. I must pay my respect. And though I came to jeer at you, I leave now with regret. So it looks like whoever came upon the body was coming to laugh at them because he says, and though I came to jeer, it says that he leaves now with regret. So maybe it was a native that was coming to like, that saw the body and was like, ha ha, you know, you guys failed to take us over. It says that I leave now with regret. Is he leaving with regret because, you know, he feels kind of sorry for the conquistador? He mentions the jewel-encrusted blade, which naturally anyone would find and like want to take that. That's the treasure. But it doesn't look like in the lyrics like he does take the blade. Almost like he's paying respect to the conquistador. Like at first he was coming to laugh at him and make fun of him. Ha ha, you failed. Look at you now. You know, you came to our land, blah, blah, blah. But at the end, it seems that he kind of has a respect for him. Even if he doesn't respect what he's done or his people have done, coming to their land and trying to take it over and all of that, it seems that he at least respects the conquistador as a person. So in the end, he just pays his respects more so than making fun of him. Anyways, I think this song was really good. This definitely gets me interested in the band because this was just a good song. Of course, let me know what you guys think of it. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. I hope that you're having an amazing day, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye.